close to best reporting for our kids first, age 15. Today, we're going to be taking a look at Nancy Drew and the Hidden Staircase. So, obviously, this is a movie adaptation of one of the Nancy Drew books, and it follows the story of Nancy as she moves to a small town called River Heights. She meets a woman named Flora who is supposedly having paranormal activity in her house, and she decides to investigate the house alongside her friends George and Bess, and Flora's mean girl niece, Helen. So, my one real issue with the film is that I felt the mystery was too easy to solve. Yes, I understand the movie is aimed at kids, but I felt even then it was a pretty simple mystery. But that's really my only issue with the film. And plus, it's not like it really ruined the film for me, because I enjoyed the character so much I didn't really think about it that much. One thing I did actually really like about this film was the mean girl character Helen. The mean girl stereotype is a trope that's been done to death at this point, and at first it seemed like she was just gonna be another mean girl character, but she's only really mean for, like, the first half of the movie, and she actually goes through a character arc, which is something I honestly didn't expect, and I feel like should be done more, so props to you, Nancy Drew, for actually putting an interesting spin on this trope. Speaking of which, the casting in this film was really, really good. Sophia Lillis as Nancy Drew breathes new light into a character that's been around since the 1930s, which is something I didn't even know. And also, the rest of the cast is great as well. Linda Lavin as Flora is such a fun character, and she was easily my favorite part of the movie. Everyone needs someone like Aunt Flora in their life, let's be real here. And also, Nancy's friends, George, who is played by Zoe Renee, and Bess, who's played by Mackenzie Graham, were great as well. I just felt like they didn't really get that much screen time. Now, as I mentioned earlier, Nancy Drew has been a character since the 1930s, which is ridiculous. Even if you've never read the books, everyone knows who Nancy Drew is. And I really do appreciate this movie for giving Nancy Drew a little bit new style. Because these books have been coming out for such a long time. And I really feel like this movie can shed a new light on a character that has been been an inspiration for so many people. So, I would give this movie 3 out of 5 stars and would recommend it for ages 7 to 18. And don't worry about not being a Nancy Drew fan if you want to see this movie, because I've never read the books and I still love this movie. And it comes out on March 15th. That'll be it for this Kids First review. If you like it, make sure to check out the Kids First website and, of course, all the other Kids First reviewers. I will see you all later. Bye-bye!